Hey Chickies! So today I'm going to be doing an all-awaited video. You guys have been requesting another Chicky Chit Chat for the longest time now, and I really apologize that I haven't filmed one, but today is the day that I do. So welcome back to Chicky Chit Chat. Today is going to be Chicky Chit Chat number 4, all about shaving down there. Now, I realize that this is a very touchy topic, so if you're going to be a little disturbed by it, then I suggest that you just click out of the video. But you know what? It's something in nature that happens. You know, if you want to shave it down there, then you're going to have to. A lot of girls do, so it really shouldn't be that awkward. But you know what? If somebody's going to talk about it on the internet, it's going to be me. I embarrass myself enough on the internet, so I have absolutely no problem talking about it. So, like I said, we're talking about shaving down there, as in shaving your vagina, as in trimming the cat. Alright, so without further ado, let's get into this video. Okay, so the first thing I want to talk about is why girls shave down there. Now, there honestly is like so many reasons why we shave down there, but these are just a couple main ones. I mean, some girls feel the need to shave down there because they'll feel cleaner. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but even when I don't shave my legs, I feel like really like awkward and weird. So I'm guessing that's kind of like what girls feel like when we don't shave down there. I mean, some feel that it's unsanitary. Some of them don't really care. It depends on who you are, really. Another main reason is for when you wear a bikini, because I'm pretty sure a girl going out wearing a bikini, wearing a bathing suit, you don't want your hair sticking out of the ends or something like that, or being visible through it. That's really not the prettiest sight. And there's obviously like a million more reasons why girls shave down there, but we're not gonna get into those. I just want to list some of the like main ones. All right, so the next thing is the big question at all. Do girls have to shave down there, their vaginas? And the answer is no. A lot of girls do shave down there because of the reasons that I listed before and many more, and a lot of them do not. Honestly, if you don't feel like shaving down there, it's not a big deal. I mean, sometimes people like a bush. So yeah, it depends on who you are and what you feel comfortable with. If you feel comfortable with leaving the bush, then go ahead. Feel comfortable with trimming it, go ahead. Feel like taking it all off, going all bald eagle on that, then go right ahead. Speaking of bushes, trimming, and bald eagle, the next thing is the different preferences of shaving, and I mean as in like what you like to do down there. Now the first one is the obvious, shave everything off. A lot of girls just, of course, shave absolutely everything off. Just everything. Everything, all hair, not visible. So the next thing is trimming your bikini area, which is basically like you don't shave all the hair off, you only shave the hair that shows in a bikini. So if you were to put on a bikini and then you see the hairs on the outside, you would just shave those off. The next thing is a trim, and that's basically when you keep most of your hair mainly, but you just give it a little trim, like if somebody's like growing out a bush or something like that, then you just take scissors and you trim it down a little bit, or you could take a razor and trim it down a little bit. So yeah. And the last one is to keep a bush, you know, just leave it. Oh yeah, and also another one that you could do is the, I believe it's called like the landing line or something like that. I forget what it's called, but it's basically when you shave everything except for just like one little line up, which I don't know. I feel like that one's like a little odd. I would not do that personally, but you know, if you want to do it, go right ahead. If you feel like growing out, go ahead. If you want to be like me and you want to shave everything off, go ahead. All right, and then the next thing is when you should start shaving. And really, you could start shaving at any age. By all means, no matter what age you are, if you want to shave the hair that's down there growing, then go right ahead. There is no age limit. All right, so now that we got all the small talk out of the way, we're talking about how do you actually shave down there. Now, there are so many different ways that girls shave down there. This is just the way that I like to do, and it works the best for me, and so, yeah, sharing it with you guys. All right, so the first thing that you wanna do is, if it's pretty long, then you wanna trim it a little bit. You know, like, take some scissors and trim down the hairs, and when you trim down the hairs, it's better because if you're shaving with very, very long hairs, then it could dull out your razor, and so you won't get a closer shave. So yeah, suggest trimming if you have a big bush. The next thing is to soak, like in a bathtub or something like that, for like 5 minutes with hot water, warm water. And if you don't feel like that, then just standing in the shower towards the shower head, hitting it down there for 5 minutes, that should be good. Or you could just use warm compress and put it up there. And the reason you're gonna do this is because it loosens up the hair follicles, makes them softer, that way you have a less chance of cutting yourself or getting razor bumps when you shave. And the next thing is to use either shaving cream or shaving gel. Now, when you're choosing a shaving cream or shaving gel to use, you can really use any of them. except the thing is that I would try to get an unscented one, because if you do get a scented one, then the perfumes could be harsh on the skin down there, since the skin is pretty sensitive. Okay, now personally, for me, I use shaving gel, and this is the one that I swear by, and this is the Bikini Zone Anti-Bumps Shave Gel for the bikini area, and right on it, it says fights bumps and irritation for smooth skin. This is the best shaving gel I have ever used. Now, I really, really do suggest going out and getting this. They sell it at Walmart, Target, any of your drugstores. And basically, it's just what it says. It's a shaving gel, but it's specifically made to fight against the bumps that you get, the red bumps, and then it's also specifically made to prevent cuts. So with this stuff, I have had less razor bumps and less cuts, and it works just fantastic. All right, now for choosing a razor to use while you shave down there is pretty important. You don't want to use a razor with like one or two blades. You want to get as many blades as you can. The more blades, the better, because you get the closer shave and the less razor bumps and cuts you're gonna get. And plus, the more blades, the faster it goes, because I mean, if you're shaving with one or two blades, it's going to take forever. Also, try to use like a pretty good razor. Like, I mean, for your legs, you can use the ones that have like the two blades or whatever, it doesn't really matter. But for when you're shaving down there, I suggest investing in a pretty good razor. So I bought a new pack of razors today, actually, and these are the ones that I normally use. These are the razors that I use, and they're a pretty thick razor, you know, but it has a nice grip. You know, that's a really good thing too. Don't get ones with like really crappy plastic handles. See if you could get one with a grip, that way it's not like slipping out when you like, yeah. This one I really do like, because as you guys could see, it has four blades, which is really, really good, you know, closer shave. And I also like it because the head of it moves, so it's easier to flow with your body when you're trying to get in places. So now that we got talking about the gels and creams done, and that we got done talking about the razors, we're gonna talk about the grain. So with shaving, you could do two different things. You could go with the grain, or you could go against it. All right, so if you decide to go with the grain, then basically what happens with that is when you're shaving, it will prevent razor bumps, so it will prevent cuts, and also it will prevent ingrown hairs. The only thing with it is that you're not going to get as close of a shave as you will with against the grain. Now, if you decide to go against the grain, then you will get a much, much more closer shave. However, with going against the grain means you have to be more careful, because it is more prone to razor bumps and to cutting. Some people are amazing and they could just do against the grain without any cuts, any razor bumps, any, like, nothing. Nothing. Personally, for me, I normally go against the grain because I want to get the closest shave that I possibly can, and it works for me. But you know, depending on what your preference is, go with it or go against it. Okay, so now that you're done with the actual act of shaving, we're gonna be talking about after you shave. Now, when you're done with shaving, you wanna make sure that you get everything off, you know, get the shaving cream off, the hair, just scrub it up dub right down there, you know, just get everything off, gone, whatever you want, off and gone. Also, when you get out of the shower, make sure to pat dry down there. Like I said from before, it is a very delicate area, so just make sure to pat dry. That way it will prevent some irritation, so yeah. Now, these next parts are optional. Some people just pat it dry and are ready to go, but these two next parts do help if you end up getting razor bumps and or cuts. So what it is to apply an ointment. Yes, an ointment. I'm not talking about like an ointment you get like prescribed from the doctor. I'm talking about like Vaseline or Neosporin. Do not use any harsh lotions, gels, or creams, especially ones that are perfumed. But yeah, what you want to do is just take a little bit of Vaseline, a little Neosporin, and just put it on the very front, you know, just spread it around a little bit, just a little bit, just a very thin coat of it. You don't want to have like a big glob. And then you either leave it like that, or what I like to do is use a little bit of baby powder. So after you do that, just sprinkle a little bit of baby powder, you know, just rub it in, blend it a little bit. Just a very thin layer of baby powder. Also, make sure to just put it like on the front where you put the Neosporin. Do not put it anywhere under. And yeah, so that is how you shave your vagina. So I hope you guys found this video very educational and hopefully use some of the tips that are in it. If you do, make sure to comment below and let me know. But yeah, I'm gonna go. So I love you, thank you so much, and thank you for watching. So, ciao, ciao, ciao.